he made laws of human production at a different pace and laws of provisions production at a different pace. So one wheel ran ahead and the other was left behind. If this is the meaning of family planning, there is no need of using any term contraception, anything at all. If this is the meaning of family planning, this is the only family planning which is forbidden in Islam. The Holy Quran categorically rejects this view because it is a renouncement of the concept of God's wisdom. Such a God is not to be believed in. What sort of Hakim al-Alim he is, you know, knows everything and is provident for the whole world, who did not know that his laws were unevenly balanced. And again, this is wrong. The history gives it a lie, because the famines never took place because of overpopulation. They were result of different causes in nature and some moral degradations among human beings. So when the population of this earth was so small as compared to now, did not famines take place? What happened at the time of Joseph? That great famine, you know, which covered not only Egypt but spilled out around, and people from different countries ran to the shelter of prophethood to seek food. Food was there, but only because God had told his prophet that there was to be a famine and the food, plenty of food would be there, don't waste it. The food is always plentiful in the world, only that it is a callousness on the part of man which is responsible for these famines which we are witnessing. The time when Ethiopia was dying of hunger, when Sudan was dying of hunger, when other parts of some Africa were dying of hunger, the problem in Europe was mountains of butter and mountains of eggs and mountains of meat, what to do with it? You see? And if somebody suggested, send it to Africa, they said, no, don't be silly, you know. Why should we send it to Africa? A trickle, of course, but not more. So it is a human failure or a failure of sometimes crops, etc., due to drought, etc. That is the obvious reason. But at the same time, in the world, in reachable vicinity, there always is food. So read the history of famines and you will see that the famines have no relationship to the number of human beings present in the world at that certain cross point of history. In all ages there have been famines, and in all ages there would be famines. It is in fact the famine of the moral values, of regard for fellow human beings, which makes a famine so disastrous. Otherwise, the world resources could be rushed to certain areas, but there are political ties, political exigencies, the political relationship with some, political hatred of some, which prevent people from, and rich people as well, who can afford it, in transporting food in time. What I'm telling you is based on hard facts. That is why the Holy Quran says, if you do family planning for the fear of paucity of food, I will not permit you that, because that would be a reflection on me. For other genuine reasons, go ahead and do it, in the sense that God has not forbidden it for other purposes. Right? Yes, please.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.
My name is Ahmed Masood.
Yes.
And I'm not new to Ahmadiyyat.
But did you say I am not new to Ahmadiyyat?
Yeah. I did my bath on 14th of March of this year. But
still you say you are not new to Ahmadiyyat. Because within this short period you have progressed so well that with the grace of Allah you have developed a sense of belonging. Is that what you mean?
Yep.
Okay, I accept it.
I have a question about I got a few habits, what do you call, they are bad habits when I was non-Ahmadi.
You don't have to mention these things in name relating, you should ask such questions in third persons. If somebody has a bad habit, that is why I objected to the way of this question was handed over to me. We can bypass some embarrassments without telling a lie. Why not? Okay?
So somebody has a bad habit of listening to music.
Okay.
My question is, what is the status of
music? You see, it all depends on, I mean, this is what you call a bad habit. It all depends on the degree of the habit and the nature of the music. If you see, the music in itself as a whole cannot be dubbed as bad. Even the wine is not dubbed by the Quran as totally bad. Even juggling and these things are not dubbed as entirely bad. What is described, in the principle described is that a thing which has overwhelmingly or more than 50% bad in it should be abandoned and rejected. A thing which has less than 50% bad things, its better things should be utilized and the bad things should be avoided. This is the principle, okay? Now music falls in the no man's land, in fact. It is neither forbidden entirely nor permitted without any conditions. We know at the time of Hazrat Muhammad Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he walked into Medina, the ladies of Medina, welcoming him, sang a song of welcome, plus they beat on the drum. This is called daf. Now, that was a sort of music available to the Arabs. Nobody can say it was not music. But this was not a practice of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to permit the companions to go on enjoying music revelries and music sessions and to be given up to music. That was not their habit. Instead, they enjoyed recitation of the Quran or listening to the good verses and meaningful verses of great poets. But gradually their taste was developed and they shifted from poetry to the Quran ultimately. So it requires some time of patience to improve the quality of your taste. And without that, to abandon certain things would be rather cruel. In these things, it's a matter of taste. In some other things, the matter of prohibition is fast and hard and you can't change it. You can't say, I have to improve my taste for water before I can stop drinking wine. No, that will not be permissible. Because wine is forbidden, and what is forbidden is forbidden. But music does not fall into that category. For that you can acquire a wise approach of systematic, gradual deliverance from that habit. You understand?
Got it.
And as far as the pop music is concerned, I don't know how people can tolerate that. Just sheer nonsense. No, I don't disrespect music altogether because I know the classical music had some nobility in it. It brought up the best in man in a way that man would not understand. But the music writers were noble-minded. They wanted to bring, even if the theme was miserable, it wanted to bring the